Five are killed and over a dozen others wounded in an attack at a Turkish aerospace industry's headquarters. The Turkish government is calling the incident a terrorist attack. Officials say several armed assailants entered the compound Wednesday. Two of them were killed by security officers. The Interior Ministry said the perpetrators were likely members of the outlawed Kurdistan Workers' Party. The company is Turkey's largest aerospace manufacturer, producing training and combat aircraft. Well, turning now to the U.S. campaign trail, the presidential contenders exchanging fresh jabs less than 2 weeks until the November 5th elections. Vice President Kamala Harris condemned former President Donald Trump for reportedly praising Nazi dictator Adolf Hitler during his time in office.
It is deeply troubling and incredibly dangerous that Donald Trump would invoke Adolf Hitler, the man who is responsible for the deaths of 6 million Jews and hundreds of thousands of Americans. All of this is further evidence for the American people of who Donald Trump really is. Donald Trump is increasingly unhinged and unstable. We know what Donald Trump wants. He wants unchecked power.
Well, in response, Trump mocked Harris, claiming the vice president is unheard of and irrelevant on the national stage.
And unfortunately, Biden and Kamala, nobody knows her as Harris. Do you ever know? I talk about it all the time. You say Harris. Everyone says, who is that? The vice president. Can you believe she's the vice president? She came in last. He picked her. She came in last. And the whole, and now she's running.
More than 100 passengers also stranded at the Manila North Port. This follows a slew of travel cancellations due to Christine. Some of the travelers say they chose to spend the night at the port to save on money as they wait for authorities to finally allow the resumption of sea travel.
Wala pong daan ako, ma'am, kasi nakaupuan na lang ako, nagahiga. Mayroon man nagbigay ng pagkain dito, pero ngayon, ako ngayon, maliit na lang pera ko, ma'am, 200 lang naiwan dito. Pero nakabili na rin ako ng ticket.
Yung ate ko mahika, hindi kami pwede umuwi ng Valenzuela kasi iniwasan din namin yung ano, yung pamasahe. Okay naman yung ano ng tugo, yung mga tao. Okay naman yung pagtaka nila dito sa amin. Okay naman po yung pagkain, mayroon naman po silang supply.
The Philippine Ports Authority says, as of the latest count, there are over 7,000 passengers stranded in various ports across the country. Two ships ran aground at the Batangas Pier Thursday due to strong waves and winds brought by Christine. Port officials say the first vessel was a domestic cargo ship that lost its anchor while in the port, with its captain nowhere to be found. The second ship, meanwhile, is a foreign fuel tanker that had previously been seized by the Customs Bureau. Port officials fear an oil leak has occurred.
Ang pinapalagay po natin ay nalagutan ito ng angkla. Nag-iimbestiga pa kung talagang ang alam talaga ay wala talagang kapitan ito. Pag pumasok po kayo sa loob ng Port of Batangas, amoy fuel na po. Sana nga po ay may ano pa, kung konti lang sana may salba.
Over 200 passengers are stranded at the Batangas port due to the adverse weather conditions caused by the storm. Well, Philippine transport regulators have issued over 1,000 special permits allowing public utility vehicles to operate beyond their usual routes during All Saints and All Souls days. This as the LTFRB anticipates an increase in travelers during the Undas break. The special permits will enable more POVs to serve routes as far south as Bicol and as far north as Cagayan and Lawak.